Now moving on to scale out. Now, scale out pretty much is a concept that I explain means that I am trying to bring in additional instances with same compute power and provide it for my web application. So the idea here is I can either do a manual scale out just by dragging along this, and the maximum number depends on the pricing tier that you are. For premium, it's up to 30. So I can either do it manually, or if I want to automate the whole experience, again, it's pretty simple to do that. So what I do here is I say, yes, I want to do it based on a metric. Click on add a rule. And you can see what's the time aggregation that I want to use for this rule to be triggered. I want to use average. What's the metric? So let's keep it simple. I want to do it based on a CPU percentage. So based on a CPU percentage, I simply say greater than, it could be greater than or equal to, less than, equal to, not equal to. There are different operators that you can use. And what's the threshold? Now, the threshold over here means that if my CPU percentage is greater than 70% for a duration of 10 minutes, please increase the count by one. So that's what this rule is going to do. And when I say cooldown period, that pretty much refers to the idea wherein before the next trigger of this rule happens, or before I get another additional instance, let's wait for 5 minutes. So that's how easy it is to create a rule. You can see average CPU percentage more than 70%, increase my count by one. You can add another scale condition this time and say, look, this time I want to do auto scale based on schedule. And again, it could be a specific start and end date, or you could also repeat it. Let's say, take a classic example. I have a web application which is used internally by my employees. So probably I would say that during the weekdays, maybe I want a maximum of 10. And a minimum of 5. Of course, in this case, my default should be between maximum and minimum. And again, not only the days, I could even define the time for which I want this to happen. Otherwise, it goes back to default. So that's another way of scaling out your web applications. I can hit save, and that's it. Now, whenever these conditions are met, my web applications will auto scale out. So that's around scale up and scale out. Now let's look at some other properties under the configuration tab here. So if I go here, I click on general settings, you can see this is where you can switch on or off always on. So currently it's off. I can just say always on to on. Now right now the ARR cookie is switched on, which pretty much means that for the same session, the request will land on the same instance of Azure App Services. I mean, my App Service plan. Now, if I have more than one instance available in my App Service plan and my web application is pretty much stateless in nature, ideally I should have it as off so that now my incoming request can be distributed across multiple instances. Hit save. You are good to go. Now, the other idea, as I said earlier, was to pretty much, you know, talk about how do I configure local cache. You do that by going to application settings. And you can say I need a new application setting. And then you create a setting called website underscore local underscore cache underscore option and give it a value of always. That means I want my site to use the local cache. So that's one setting. The second is I can also set the size of the local cache that I want to use. And again, I do that using another application setting. I say website underscore local underscore cache underscore size in MB. And I say 1000, which is almost a gig. So that's how I enable local cache for my web application. Now the next in line is the front door. If you remember, I spoke about front door being the HTTP or rather a global HTTP load balancer based on DNS for my web application in a scenario where I have the web application code base hosted, let's say in East US, it's hosted in North Europe, it's hosted in Southeast Asia. So I have these different locations where my same web application is hosted. And what I want is I want my user to be automatically redirected or routed to a geographical location which is closest to them. So that's what the Azure front door will provide for me. And it's very simple to configure. I mean, this is the front door experience itself, where I have the front door front end domains and the default backend pool defined. And I can again come back and define all the rules that I want. This is where I configure for the web application firewall. And again, there's a set of managed rules which are already defined for you, as you can see. You can even have your own custom rules if you want. Now, how is this whole thing pulled together for my web application? So that was the whole front door experience. Now, in terms of hooking this on to my web applications, it's very simple. Look, I already have created I have already integrated my web application with this whole Azure front door instance. Otherwise, it's just a drop down and you select the name of your front door instance to have your web application use the capabilities of Azure front door. So that's around Azure front door. Similarly, when I talk about CDN, the whole idea is that you first create a CDN profile, and within a CDN profile, you go ahead and create an endpoint. Now, again, on CDN, one very important point to remember is that Microsoft, again, is very uniquely positioned where we provide you different options in terms of CDN providers. So you have the Microsoft CDN option, you have the Verizon, and you have Akamai. And it's up to you based on your needs and requirements to choose the right provider for you. Once you have the CDN, once you have the CDN profile and endpoint created, again, you can even get your custom domain configured for your CDN endpoint. You can define what kind of formats do you want to compress. You can even define caching rules. If you want to have scenarios where you want your application to be available only to a certain set of geographies or countries, you can do that using geo-filtering. You can say that what kind of optimized do you want for your web application. Right now it's just general web delivery, but for Verizon option, you also get options around media, and you can even define rules if you want. So you can define if my device type equals mobile, add an action. Maybe I can have a different cache expiration if it's a mobile, incoming request is from a mobile, or I could do a URL redirect. So, I mean, these are all different capabilities that you can set up. Now, the idea again here for CDN is that now CDN takes care of delivering that static content for your web application, which could be images. And sometimes images can be really heavy. It could be videos, which could again be certain, which could be multiple gigabytes. So that's the kind of performance optimization that you can get by delivering your content from edge locations closest to your customers, rather than having the round trip all the way back to the origin for your web applications. And again, how do I configure very simple because I already had one. It's configured. Otherwise, from within the Azure App Services experience, you can always go ahead and create a new endpoint. Look at the example here. I can choose what's my provider, give it a name, give it the origin, and good to go. That's how easy you can configure Azure CDN.